too.
Thanks for showing up at Say What, not going to Velvet Underground. Picturing all these people on Queen West going like, where's the show? Why is everybody offering me cocaine? Which, you know, we're not quite there yet. That's the next set.
It's also not the right drug either. Yeah.
No.
That's true.
Not at all. So we did this last year, and you all wanted us to do it again, so here we are. So thank you for inviting us back. And we're doing a special treat because we're doing the second album, White Light, White Heat, after this. So I hope you're ready for a long night, because so are we. We're going to have some fun together. And we have decided to call ourselves Das Klün. Yeah, you may have seen those stickers around.
We got stickers.
See, the reason for that, if you've heard this before, well, you're going to hear it again. When the Velvet Underground started, Andy Warhol offered to pay for everything and fund their stuff, but he said one condition. I have this model actress named Nico, and let her sing a few songs, put her in the band, and then we have a deal. And you know Lou Reed being Lou Reed. See, Nico's, we said before she was German, she's actually Hungarian. So the syllable Aun is really difficult for Nico to pronounce. So in every song that Nico has to sing, you'll find the word clown, down, hand me, down, gown, over and over again, because she's like, clown, down. And you can just picture Lou Reed going like, yeah, Andy, fuck you here. I'll write some songs for her to sing. Yeah. This is one of those songs. And Taylor's going to play the role of Nico.
You better watch your step.
thousand dreams and would he wake me? Different colors made of tears. We'll be right back.
Sarah had a golden nose, hobnail boots wrapped around her toes. When she turned blue, all the angels screamed. They didn't know, couldn't make the scene.
When midnight Sail the darkened seas on a great big clipper ship, going from this land here to that, in a sailor's suit and cap. Thank you.
Thank you.
Robb Johannes, everybody.
That is quite the place to travel to. Oh, thank you. I try. Oh, shit. Sorry, when Indians see other Indians, that's how we respond. Oh, buddy! So I was on my way here tonight, and this guy's real angry-looking young guy said to me, "Hey, your pants are too tight." And I said, "Not as tight as your ass when I'm through with you." He ran away. So I said, "You should see the ones I'm gonna wear on stage." I thought that'd be a fitting story to tell. It's June 1st. It's the first day of Pride Month. We're at the south end of Church Street here. There's an old adage that only 10,000 people bought this record, but everyone who did went out and started a band. I'm probably one of those. I know Spacker's another one. R.E.M. did a version of this song, actually, and we're going to do one, too. Get this out of my chest. You know, a lot of people say to me, wow, I wouldn't have thought you were Indian at all. Because apparently to be Indian, I need to be wearing a turban and talking like this. So, whoa, I must be in a room full of white people. Okay. Jesus Christ. This is the worst time to go into this part here now. So, it's the fun part. I always debate with comedians about who has a harder job, and they think I do, and I say, no, you guys do, because if I tell a shit joke, boom, the band starts.
It's an easy way to bail.
Everyone's forgotten about it. We have some posters here for the show if you want one. And we can sign it for you after the show.
There are probably some stickers.
Just throw an extra $5 in a cup there, and we'll sign posters for you after. And throw that in there anyways, because it's not free to come up here. And thanks to Miles for doing the sound here and always having us. Yeah.
Thanks, Miles. I'm being a real dick to Miles. I'm the noisy guy. I'm not making his job easy.
Since we're going to be here for another set, you may as well get to know who the hell we are, actually. Noisy guy there. He just moved to California, and he came back for this show. That's Spacker Dave Vestaloyne there. You know, you always thought wearing sunglasses on stage was to look cool. It's actually because Andy Warhol used to just project shit on the band all the time. So they would do it to protect their eyes. And Dan McCormick's been a real trooper here, being half a projection surface and being the most entertaining drummer in the city. So give it up for Dan. He has eyes. Every time this man enters the room, he just kind of warms it up with his gentle presence. And he's actually just finishing school to be a massage therapist. So you know what I'm doing after the show. That's Kirk Philipps over there on the bass. This is really a Velvet Underground show. I'd be going to pick up dope afterwards, but, you know, I did that beforehand. last summer, we did four different 1967 tributes for the 50th anniversary. We did the Velvet Underground, we did the Beatles, we did Jimi Hendrix, and we did the Doors. And this is the one that's come back, thanks to you, and he's done all of these ones together.
Oh, you're talking about me.
With me.
Yeah.
My turn.
He's probably my biggest partner in crime in the whole city, as far as the music scene goes, and those people are really hard to find, and he's very, very dear to my heart. So give it up for Colin James Gibson on the guitar.
Thank you. I love you all. I especially love you. I love you guys, too.
And I think the first time we met a couple of years ago, we both confessed recently that we knew instantly we were probably going to be friends, soulmates or whatever for life. And I'm really honored every time I get to be on the stage with her. The lovely Taylor Cawes on the keyboards and the vocals. Always a pleasure. So this is another Nico song.
Stand to show that you
So we got a friend back there who got the memo about wearing the stripes and the black. The Edie outfit there, yeah. Thank you for that. Going over and above.
Red, 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 red.
Floyd played with a forehead before. That was fucking awesome.
Where am I?
If you know this record, you know this is the last song. It ain't nearly the end, but it's the last song. And then we'll take a short break. We'll be back doing White Light, White Heat.
was fun. Stick around for the second set. We're doing White Light, White Heat next.